Namaste. My name is JVN Rishi Gautam from Department of Journalism. Today's topic is how communication breaks down. If everyone were to have the same experiences, all messages would be encoded, transmitted, and decoded alike. Symbols would have the same meaning for everyone, and all communication would be received as the senders intended. However, people differ in their personal histories, ways in which they experience things, and emotional responses, leading to differences in the ways in which communications are encoded, transmitted, received, and understood. Different people attach different meanings to the words, pictures, sounds, and gestures used during communication. Differently, with the encoding and decoding of images, is not the only factor that affects the effectiveness of communication between people. Adler and Towney use the concept of noise to describe physical and psychological forces that can disrupt communication. Physical noise refers to conspicuous distractions in the environment that make it difficult to hear or pay attention. For example, when the environment is excessively hot or excessively cold, or when one is in a noisy nightclub, one may tend to focus more concern on the situation than on the message. Physical noise can inhibit communication at any point in the process, in the sender, in the message, in the channel, or in the receiver. Psychological noise alludes to mechanisms within individuals that restrict a sender's or receiver's ability to express and or understand messages clearly. For example, senders with limited vocabularies may have difficult translating images into symbols that can be understood easily by receivers. Receivers with inflated self-concepts may filter messages that disagree with her. They disagree with their self-perceptions and put energy into defending themselves rather than into understanding the messages. Psychological noise most often results in defensiveness that blocks the flow of communication between sender and receiver. Within the many ways in which communications can be encoded, channeled, and decoded, there is little wonder why so many difficulties exist when people attempt to communicate with one another. Yet, communication processes become more complex. Discussing communication in terms of sender, receiver implies one-way communication. However, human communication often is a two-way process in which each party shares sending and receiving responsibilities. As the quantity of people taking part in a communication increases, the potential for errors in encoding and decoding increases, along with the potential for physical and psychological noise. Thank you.